We want to convert this NFA to DFA. So once again Q and summation. So once again P Q R S P Q P R P S then Q R Q S, right? So combination with QR and QS is over. Next combination is RS. So all 2-2 combinations are over. Next 3 combination PQR, then PQS, PQS. Next is PRS. And finally you will be having PQRS, right? So once again we'll count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Anything is repeated. PQ, PR, PS, QR, QS, RS, then PQR, PQS, then PRS, PRS, QRS, and finally PQRS. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Better it, I will write here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So these are the 15 states, right? And now here for the two symbols, which are those 0 and 1, we have to write down the things. So here what was our problem? Our problem was related to, okay, so the problem was, it is having table, where I kept it. Okay, let me take the help of book so that we can move quickly. Just now I have written down. Okay, so let it be. I'm just copying. Just verify PQ, P, then we will be having all the states same as your NFA, R, R, S, dash, and for fourth state we had SS. Finally, we have to do the combinations. So how I will do combination? So next state is PQ. So PQ means combination of this and this. So it will be union of these two rows. So it will give you PQR, right? Similarly, I will need the combination of these two. Have you done it? Similarly for PR, it will be P and R. So we have to now combine these two rows, PQ and S. So it will be PQS and P and dash. So it will be only P. Next, PS. So this is your P state and this is your S state. So I need to do union of this and this. So it will become again PQS and PS, right? Now QR. So now I need to combine these two states, Q and R, right? So it will become RS and again it is only R. Now for QS, QS will be R, and so Q is R and it is S. So I need to combine it with this row. Okay, so RS. So it will again be RS. Next, here also I need to do same thing. It is QR. So Q and R. It is nothing. Our turn of QR is over. QS we are talking about. So QS. So it is Q and it is S. So it is nothing but RS. Right? Next. RS, we need to combine these two rows now. So it is S only and it is also S. Then PQR, now we need to combine these two rows, PQR. So after combining these two rows, PQR and S. So it will become PQRS for PQR. Similarly, PR. Next, PQS. So PQS. So first, second and fourth row I need to, first row and fourth. So again it is first, second and fourth. So it is again PQRS, PR and S. Next, we need to combine now PRS. PQS is over, PQS is over. Now PRS, we have to combine first, third and fourth row. First, third and fourth row. So it is PQS, first, third and fourth. First, third and fourth, PS. Finally, QRS. So last three rows I need to combine. So last three rows, RS and again RS. And finally, PQRS. PQRS, it will be what? All the first four rows we need to combine. So after combining all the four rows, PQRS. PQRS. PRS. So just verify, have you written same way your table for 15 states? So what is a simple way? You very first copy all the contents of your NFA. This was your NFA, right? So it will be as it is in DFA, and now additional states will be what? 5 to 15, right? Now what is to be done? Whatever is your combination, you have to do union of it. So I hope this much you have already done. Now we are moving to a concept of the DFA minimization. So we are doing DFA minimization. What this means? This means that now if we will draw a finite automata, that is deterministic finite automata for given NFA, it will be having how many states? It will be having 15 states, right? DFA will have 15 states where many states are of no use. So one example I have given where one state was there in NFA which is trapping you. That means once you reach to that state, there is no further state where you can move and nor you can reach to final state. So such type of transitions are of no use and they should be discarded. And when we discard such type of moves, we have minimized the DFA. So how to minimize the DFA? So before minimizing DFA, one more thing we need to do. Now what was our final state in given NFA? So this was our initial state, right? And which was our final state? So they have given final state as S, right? So very first we need to now nominate whether the states, so we know already PQR are non-final state, these are called as non-final states, and S is a final state in given NFA. But now in a final DFA, we will be having some of the states or maybe all of the states from this total 15 states, right? So in that case, what we need to do is we need to finalize that which will be the final state and which will be non-final state. So what was the way to finalize whether the given state in a resultant DFA is final or not? How we do it? We consider all those states in which this final state representation is there. So which are those states? This is one, because S is appearing. Next, this is also final state. This is also final state. This is also final state. This is also final state, and this is also final states. So total how many final states? So F dash will be what? My S, then PS, then QS, then PQS, then PRS, then Q PQRS and finally PQRS. All these states will be my final states, right? Now when we do the minimization of DFA, so this is DFA is ready. Even if you will give this kind of output result for a given problem, you will get some marks, half marks you will get, but this is not a final DFA. That's why your marks will get cut. Okay, you have designed DFA but not a minimized DFA. So now we want to minimize it. So what are the rules? Very first, we want to find out the equivalent states. What do you mean by equivalent states? Equivalent states means, if, listen carefully, if you are this entries for given symbol is, that means total row is matching for the same type of state, then those states are called as equivalent state. For example, now here very simply I can show you, if you will observe this table, in this table if you will see this particular row and if you will see this particular row, what is the observation? Here for 0 and 1, both the symbols you are having same entry, SS, and here also SS. So whole row, this row content should be same. This is one condition. Second condition is, yes, RS is also a final state, which I missed here. Yes. So RS is also my final state, right? Because it is having S. Now when these two rows are having same entries, whether they are equivalent, they will be equivalent if and only if they are of same type. Same type in the sense, either both should be non-final state or both should be final state. Is it clear? Now we have observed that S is also final state and this RS is also final state, right? So here we can conclude that the state S is equivalent to state RS. Is it clear? What is the requirement to check the equivalence of two states? If their entries for both the symbols is same, matching, as well they are of same type. Okay. So here first thing is what? Our first state is S and RS. Now tell me which are the other final or non-final state, which are the other states which are equivalent. So here next combination, just check PQP, is it available anywhere? No. RR, is it available anywhere? No. Then S dash, is it available anywhere? No. Then SS, we have already written down. Next, PQR and PR, this combination, is it available? PQR, nowhere is find out. Next, PQS and P. So PQS is there, but here no P is there, so we can't consider this. Okay, so PQS and PS, yes, we have got one combination which is matching. Which are those? So second combination is, what it is? Next combination is the PS, PQS and PS, and PQS and PS. Is it matching? Okay. Now, whether we should nominate those as equivalent state, again we need to verify whether those are same type of states or not. So PS is also final state and PRS is also final state. So we can show the equivalence here. So next equivalence will be what? The PRS, that is PS is equivalent to PRS, right? Now next, any more combination are you able to see? Now we have just checked it, RS and R combination. Are you able to see this combination RS and R? Nowhere. Next, RS. Is it available? Yes, it is available, RS. Now, let us check the type of states. Now, RS, it is final state. RS, and it is also final state. So, yes, we can consider this combination also as equivalent state. Are you able to understand? So, which is the next state which is matching? So, the third state which is matching is what? The QS is equivalent to your, which one? This QRS. Right? Now, any more combination? Again, we will move PQRS-PR. Is this combination is available? PQRS-PR? No. PQRS-PRS. PQRS-PRS, yes, it is available. So now we will try to again check. So this is PQRS and this is PRS. This is PQRS-PRS. Now check whether it is a final state. Yes, this is also final state. So yes, we can take it as if equivalent states. Clear? So now, what is our next final state, equivalent state? It will be PQS is equivalent to your PQRS, right? So we have considered all the combinations. I hope after this it is a PQS which is already marked here. So all states are now considered. So from this particular table, what we have observed? We have observed that there are certain states which are having same type of transitions. And if we will separately mark in a transition graph this state, they will show the same transition. So better to discard such states because they are representing same state. Okay? Because they are showing same transitions. So what we will do is, now we will try to minimize and replace. So what will be replaced by what? So here if we will see the numbers, so what is the number for S? It is 4, is equivalent to RS. RS is 10, right? Next is 7 is equivalent to, where it is? PRS, where it is PRS, this is equivalent to this PRS, which is 13, right? Next, QS is 9, it is matching with QRS, which is 14, and finally, PQS is state number 12 and state number 15. So, we found 4 is equivalent to 10, 7 is equivalent to 13, 9 is equivalent to 14, and 12 is equivalent to 15. Right? So, now considering this, we will try to minimize. So, what we will do? We will discard all those entries which are in the lower part. Lower part in the sense. So, whichever are the greater numbers, those states we will discard. So there will be no states like PQRS, okay, because it is having, okay, we'll start from top. So 10, this state we don't have, we don't want this state, this will be replaced. Now wherever this RS is appearing in this whole table, that RS will be replaced by the equivalent state S. Okay, wherever, because in right hand side you can have any entry for RS. So if you will delete this particular row, then it will not find that RS state. Okay, so we need to cut down this state as well as we have to replace wherever this RS is appearing by the S. Right, so second which will be discarded is 13th row. So 13th row will also be discarded, and here we will be having what replacement? wherever we will be getting PRS, it will be replaced by PS. Next, 14 is equivalent to 9. Okay, so 14, it will also be removed from the table and hence it will be replaced. So QRS will be replaced by QRS will be replaced by QS. And finally, this will also be deleted and you will be replacing everywhere in a table PQRS, which will be replaced by PQS. So can I say now my 4 rows are deleted out of 15 rows? Okay, so it is curtailed, it is minimized. Okay, so after minimization, my table will look like this. So it is Q. Okay, and this is my alphabet. So it is 0, 1, and which are my states now? So can I write only numbers? So if I write only the numbers, my states will remain will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is there, yes, 7, 8, 9. Okay, now which states I have removed? I have removed the very first 10 number of state. Okay, so 10 number state will not be there, so I will directly write now 11. Then what about the next state? See here. So 10 number state is deleted, 11 number is present and we need to make entry for it. 11 is there. What about 12? 12 is also existing, right? Then 13, 14, 15 all are deleted. So finally I am having how many states in my DFA? I will be having which states? P, Q, R, S, then P, Q, R, P, Q, S, then P, Q, P, R, then P, S, then Q, R, 8 number is Q, R, 9 number is Q, S, 11 number is PQR and my 12 number is, which is my 12 number? My 12 number state is PQS. So I'll write here PQS. So this many will be my state. So this is PR, right? 6 number state. Now we need to write down the entries in it. So how to write down the entries? So first 4 rows will be as it is, no changes will be there, and you can replace here by the numbers as well. So it is PQ, P, R, R, S, dash, S, S. I have just copied. And what are the numbers of those states? So PQ is 5, P is 1, R is 3, S is 4, nothing, and 4 and 4, right? Next, now PQ. Now see here, PQ is having what entry? PQ is having entry PQR and PR. Whether PQR named state is available in our resultant DFA, it is available. So there is no problem, we can put it as it is. PQR, what is its number? It's 11, right? And next What is the next entry? PR. Whether PR named state is available? Yes, it is available. Which is the number of this PR? It is 6. Is it? So I will write here PR, which is 6 number state. Next, PR. This is your PR. PR. So PR is having what entry? PQS and P. Whether PQS state is available in resultant? Yes, it is available. So I need to write PQS, which is 12 number state, and P, which is first state. Next, PS. PS is having entry PQS. PQS is available again. So it will be PQS and 12, and there is a PS. Now whether PS is available here? Yes, PS is available. So I need to write PS, which is that state, which is 7th number state. Next, QR. So here QR is having entry for RS. Right? Now see here change. Here in state number, which one? 8. This is my state number 8. There is an entry for RS. Now RS is available in my this resultant table. It is nowhere present. Okay. This RS named state is discarded. Right? And I need to replace all RS with the S. So wherever this RS is present, I will write here S. Is it clear? So since RS is not present, it will be replaced by its equivalent state S, which is having number 1. 1 or 4? It is 4. Right? Then R. R is present. So I will just write here R, which is 3rd number state.